And we will finish then tonight with Denise talking about favorite Web 2.0 tools. Please, let's all give our attention for 6 minutes and 40 seconds. Put your hands together to welcome Denise.
Today I'm going to talk about Web 2 tools. Web 2 tools like Facebook, Twitter, blogs or podcasts. And I think we can use them in our classrooms to make our lessons more effective and to engage our learners more. The first one is Edmodo. It's like the combination of Facebook and Twitter. You can put your photos or you can send tweets to your students. You can use the calendar to announce quiz dates. Or you can send files to your students, assignments. You can do everything with that. And my students just love it because it's like another Twitter for education. This is posterior. As I said, blogging is web 2. And some people think it's really difficult because they don't know how to blog. But if you use posterior, you just send them an email message. And then your email message transfers into a blog. So with only one email, you can have your own blog. This is Podomatic. Have you ever used podcasts in your classes?
Yes.
And some people think it's really difficult because they don't know how to create podcasts. But with this tool, you can just press record and either record your voice or have your students record their voices, or you can just upload an audio file. Penzoom is another application which you can use to give feedback to your students' written work, or you can have them create their own vocabulary journals online. I've used this and my students love it. And then soon I'll talk about the next one, WordPress. We can use them in our reading lessons to teach, to have our students guess the content of the reading text they are going to read, or my friend David uses it in his classroom in academic writing, and he has his students paste their writings into WordClass, and it's wonderful. Glossaries are posters. You can use them in your classes as an icebreaker. You can talk about yourself. They are online posters. You can add content like audio files, video files, or you can copy links to other sites. And if you have an interactive whiteboard, there are some great applications to use them with. Wallvisor is an online notice board where you can post different formats of files, like audio files, YouTube videos, or just links to other websites. This is like securing the content when you want your students to research something online. If you VoiceThread is an online platform where your students can upload video files, audio files, and then comment on them. So it's good practice for all in the classroom. The next one is
comment.
Purpose. Assessment is a must in classroom. So if you want to create online quizzes, this is the tool to use. And you don't even need paper or pen. You just create your quizzes online and send them to your students, and your students in your classrooms use their smartphones to do the quizzes online. So there is no cheating because you can create individual quizzes for each and every student. Animoto is another great tool where you can create movies by adding pictures or your own video files and then text maybe. You can use it to talk about yourself, show a video to your students on your first day of class. Devolver is a good to use during the production stage. There are some various kinds of interaction. It's like a cartoon animated animation where students can enter lines and practice any language they want. Funny stuff comes out when students finish their works and send their links. GPT is a tool where you can create timelines. So you can talk about biographies, you can talk about yourself, or you can talk about Gaddafi and all the things going on in the Middle East if you are a history teacher. And the next one will be video sharing. You can use videos to teach productive skills, which we will talk about in our workshop tomorrow. But then you can use those two things to make videos like LinkedIn. You can add subtitles to your videos. If you go to Universal Subtitles or Overstream, it means you can add subtitles to any movie you want. Section, if you are going to use YouTube videos, you might want to get rid of the ads and you might want to make it more secure for your learners. So if you copy and paste the YouTube link to that thing, you will only have, you will, your students will only see the video you want. They will not be, there won't be anything else. Word Madness by Russell, I learned this on his webpage. And you can do, if you have a smart board in your classroom, you can get your students to do various activities with words, Word Madness. This is also a great application. And Tiny Chat is a visual chat room. You can either form your own chat room and have your students come into that room to chat with each other with their webcams, or they can go into any chat room to talk to, with foreigners, which is good practice for them, and they love it. Chindu is a cartoon maker. You can use this for any purpose, and because it is fun and easy to use, it's fun. They like to see me talking to them in an interactive way, and you can always use screencasting to give lessons online when you're away, so you can record a video of yourself, send it to your students when you're away. I learned all these tools I talked about today from my PLN, like from the people I have in my Twitter account, like Nick over there, Lindsay over there, Gavin over there, so I thank them. Because they are my teachers, and like I urge you to use Twitter if you don't have one. Thank you.
All right. Okay. Have you?